السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله ذي الملك والملكوت ذي العزة والجبروت الحمد لله حي قيوم لا ينام عزيز لا يضام قهار لا يرام وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما. يقول الباري سبحانه وتعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Oh, you who believe, fear Allah as you should be feared, and die not except on the state of Islam. For may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, bestow upon us the gift to die on the state of Islam. Allahumma ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. Amma ba'd, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Az-Zumar, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: أفمن شرح الله صدره للإسلام فهو على نور من ربه فويل للقاسية قلوبهم من ذكر الله أولئك في ضلال مبين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah given the parable for those who Allah expand their breast to accept the deen of Allah, to surrender, to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they received enlightenment and light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, woe to those who have their heart or whose heart has been hardened from the or against the remembrance of Allah. Those are in utter, distraction, diverted from the way of Allah, and those are the astray one. In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's telling us that the believer, or the one that is being guided to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, being provided by Allah a light. And this light, if the believer try to understand, to define, we have to go back to see the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah An-Nur, and the name of the surah is the light. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is قَالَ اللَّهُ نُورُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Allah is the light of the heaven and the earth. Now the light, as you know, Allah is the source of the light of the universe. And the meaning of the light, as the scholar and mainly Al-Imam Al-Ghazali, in his book of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, have defined the light as al-dhuhur, the appearance. And one of the definition of the appearance is the appearance from the nothingness, the darkness of the nothingness, to the light of the existence. Therefore, it is everything that exists. It comes, it has its existence, its essence from Allah, and it cannot hide from Allah, and only exists by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these some of the meaning of the light. So when we say the light, it is that light that is spread in one's body to give it life, in one's limbs to act, in one's brain to think, in one's heart to be alive with the iman. Therefore, we have the light that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it to be the essence of the existence, because when you think, if the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala been taken away, everything will perish. Everything will perish without the light of Allah. That's why Allah is the light of the heaven and the earth. However, there is a light that everyone had it by the essence of the existence, to exist, to be seen, to act, to talk, to think, to build. But there is another light that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in the realm of the free will. And this light, it is in abundance all over us. However, the people, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in this ayah, those who do not make the steps toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gain this light, though they put themselves into a dark place, so they are making a veil between them and the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is an abundance in this whole universe. That's why in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, people are asleep. When they die, they wake up. And then they wake up where they see the light, because they put themselves in kind of a shell of darkness, that they make themselves to be distant and make a veil, make a wall between them and the light. And here the believer, as we know, this light, it really represents the true existence for the believer, the essence of the believer. And we can say it is the identity of the believer. And it's very important that you hear many times talking about the identity, because the identity is what make us as a believer, as Muslim, what make you. It's not your identity, what you have in your passport or your ID. Your identity is made by you, who you are. It's not the color, it's not the status, it's not anything of that. It's like your action, what you believe, that what make you who you are. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provide you this light as the identity. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that the believer becomes a beacon of light. He becomes a light walking among people. Therefore, the necessity to have the light, because this light that you're going to need in this life and in the hereafter, without this light, someone will be lost in the day of judgment and will be, wal'iyadu billah, thrown in the hellfire, as we're going to examine it later, bi'idhnillah. So the necessity for the believer to look for the light has first to define this light. This light, it is in abundance. And we want, as a believer, to try to get as much light as you can. As Allah, this is what, أَتَّقُوا اللَّهَ مَسْتَطَعْتُمْ. Fear Allah as much as you can. So the fearing of Allah as much as you can is actually collecting light.
And in the same time, to protect, to shield yourself from anything that put you in a dark spot that would be, subhanAllah, make between you like a gap or like a veil between you and the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is for the believer to understand. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned a whole surah that he called the light and nur. But before that, the first step for the true believer, sincere, and we are in these beautiful days, in these blessed days, is upon every believer sincere who's seeking the pleasure of Allah, who's seeking to honor himself, who's seeking to honor herself, is truly in this last 10 days that is coming, we have, with the help of Allah, if we are true sincere believer, to collect as much light as you can. Because that light you need it in every moment in your life, and especially at the time that your soul departs from your body, then when you're going to see the true light and you're going to see how much this light that you have been collecting during your life is honoring you. So it is a necessity. It is a necessity of essence of existence, of living, and also of being saved and admitted in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first thing for the believer that we know, and before I go further to remind you that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha said, when the night, the last 10 nights or the last 10 days of Ramadan started, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he intensified, he doubled his ibadah. He said he will wake up his family to worship, and he will stand praying the whole night, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then qala jadda wa shadda al-mi'zar, and it is a metaphor of being very, very serious, very devoted, very dedicated. So imagine we're talking about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best of the worshipper, the greatest, all of the pious and the righteous. He is, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, doubling the effort. Why? Because Allah is offering you such an opportunity of one night that you can collect a light for 80 or more than 80 years. And this is a fact. It's a reality. It is true, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in surah, in the Quran, Laylat al-Qadr, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he explicit and he expressed it with his own action. And you are truly lover of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and believer in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we have to take this very serious, and a serious as honoring for ourselves. The first thing that we need to have is to regard the belief that you have in your heart as a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You didn't gain this belief by your own skills or by your own knowledge or because you're born Muslim or because of any other factor. This iman that you have in your heart, it is a gift, is Allah who poured it into your heart. And this is the first thing that we need to think about, because this is first the action, the first step of truthfulness, of sidq with yourself, is first to acknowledge the gift that you have. And if you acknowledge it as a gift, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the Bedouin, those who came into the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to show their favor on the Prophet that they accepted Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to him, said, لَا تَمُنُّوا عَلَيَّ إِسْلَامَكُمْ. Don't, you know, push, show that you have made the favor on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you accepted Islam. Is indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has bestowed upon you the gift to be a believer if you are true, truly truthful. Truthful to your iman, truthful to your belief, truthful to Allah, truthful to yourself. When you know that is a gift from Allah, and when you say, you know, all of us we know, but you have to have it in your mind, you present in your mind, you said, this iman that I have, the fact that you came today, Friday, Jumu'ah to pray, it is a gift from Allah. What drive you to do it is the iman inside your heart. That iman is Allah put that iman in your heart. It's a gift. Therefore, as a gift, also you have to regard it as a guest. The iman is a guest. You don't own it. He can leave at any time. As Al-Imam Sufyan al-Thawri, he was in deep tears, weeping by the end of his life when they told him, why you are doing, mashallah, you are our imam and teacher. He said, at this last moment, I am really scared. I fear that Allah will take the iman from me. It's a gift. It's a guest. A gift, which is a guest. And Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, none of you is a believer if he does not honor or she does not honor their guest. And the guest, we're talking normal guests. So what do you think of a guest of Allah who will give you life and is the source of your joy in this life and the hereafter? And then it required to really, really be, you know, taken care of, maintained and honored truly honored. So the iman is not something you pushing yourself to pray, for example, or you pushing. No, you have to honor that iman. You have to serve that iman as your guest. A guest of who? Guest from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to you. وَمَا كَانَ لِنَفْسٍ أَن تُؤْمِنَ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. There were no single soul who could have been believer except by the permission of Allah in Surah Yunus. Then the next step, you say, how can I maintain? So I know it's a gift. How am I going to honor this gift? You know, when you have a gift, a guest at your home, mashallah, you honor them with great food, the best thing that you can offer to them, and you have, you know, cleaned the house and make it so presentable and so on. This is how you need to do with this iman. Therefore, you're going to check what are the elements that is going to help you to honor this iman, to increase this iman, to safeguard this iman, for this iman to help you, to serve you, to guide you, to illuminate you, to open your eyes, to make you someone who's driven toward the righteousness and the good action. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the whole surah, his name Surah An-Nur. And from the Surah An-Nur, we're going to see in a very, you know, summarized and concise way how in three levels or three ways, or you divide it in three sections. In three sections, how you need to be as a believer, and this is the building of the identity, to be like the light of Allah on the earth. That's why Isa alayhi salam qala wa ja'alani mubarakan aynama kuntu. He made me blessed wherever I will be. And this is true for every believer. Every believer, when you become a beacon of light, when you become a light among people, walking among people, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said it in Surah Al-An'am, قَالَ أَوَمَنْ كَانَ مَيْتًا فَأَحْيَيْنَاهُ وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا يَمْشِي بِهِ فِي النَّاسِ. The parable of the one that he was dead, and Allah gave them life, and he made them to be a light walking among people. Can he be compared to the one sinking into the darkness and who could not ever get out of it? Because the light is only from Allah. And whoever who's seeking light from any other system, there was no light. قَالَ اللَّهُ وَمَنْ لَمْ يَجْعَلِ اللَّهُ لَهُ نُورًا فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ نُورٍ. The one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not provide light, he will never be able to get the light. Because whatever people they think as knowledge, they have a light and guidance, and all what you see people, you know, meditation and, you know, kind of a spiritual cleansing, development, all of it ends by the grave. If they are ignorant and they are heedless, all of it is end by the grave, because the only light that enters the grave with you is the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. None of the other light will be admitted or be regarded or even subhanallah being considered. So here, there is the three sections that we taken from Surah An-Nur. And this is very important to see, dear brother, respected sister, that Islam is not about just you pray and we said, Alhamdulillah, I make a lot of great dhikr today. That's not enough. And we say it's not enough, it's not like you're not doing much. No. It's about the structure. It's about the structure. It's about the balance. It's not about how much you're doing. It's about the balance. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us in Surah An-Nur that he called the light, and Allah mentioned in it the ayah that Allah is the light of the heaven of the earth. The first section is your akhlaq, is your morality, is your behavior. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put them in a very, you know, summarized way. To be a pure person, you have a tongue that is pure, to not hurt people, to not belie, to not have, subhanAllah, words like that happened to Sayyidah Aisha, the big lie that they forged against Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. And the Prophet, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, do not think that is bad for you. Even the hurting that caused Aisha, but it was great for the next generation and for the generation of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to know how important to preserve the iman, the guest into your heart, and to increase the light in your heart. First, you have to safeguard your tongue. So this is the akhlaq. When you look at yourself, you look at yourself, what you are speaking, what you are saying. Are you pure into your heart? Are you pure into subhanAllah, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qala afifun, tayyibun, pure. Look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qala, the pure women are for a pure man, and pure men are for a pure woman. Those who safeguard their tongue, those who have a good thinking about other, those who do not accuse other with falsehood. And this is very important. This is part of the iman. It's very important because many of the Muslims, they do not even think that this is part of the deen. No, it is actually part of the identity. When I see the, I say the identity, it's the core system structure of the believer. So this is the part of the akhlaq, of the behavior, of the suluk. It is the part we're going to safeguard and protect that iman that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in your heart as a guest. This is the first thing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue, he said, help yourself by lowering the gaze. Help yourself by protecting your modesty. And all of that is part of the identity of the believer. When I say identity again, is how to safeguard and maintain and preserve and increase that iman which is the gift. The iman which is your life. Not only give you the life with which you walk among people, but it is your life. Without it, will be sinking in the darkness. Therefore, if we do not lower our gaze, if you do not care about modesty, if you do not watch what we say, if you are backbiting and gossiping and loving to watch gossip, loving to hear gossip, then we are killing the iman. Then we are denying and, subhanAllah, belittling the guest that we have. Imagine you have a dear guest that people they respect, and he's at your home, and you didn't even present for him anything, and then you are like away, you know, doing something else in your office, and this person is gonna end up by leave, because why? He feel like he was like really disgraced. When he came back, you say, where did he go? This is exactly what happening to many of us for the iman. Say, where is my iman? How can you find that? Because you don't want even to come to the prayer. You know, if there is any excuse, he said, no, I have the excuse, I don't want to even go to the Jumu'ah, and so on. And subhanAllah, this is a sign for us that that iman, it might not be there anymore. So this is the first section. The second section is like in the relation with the people, in the relation. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and this ayah was for Abu Bakr. Imagine someone who was hurting, you know, Abu Bakr in his irdh, in his honor, when he was talking about Sayyidah Aisha. And he was someone that the Abu Bakr, he was giving him money. He was, you know, give him his sustenance every month or every other day, he will give him what to eat. So he was taken, you know, he was under the charge of Abu Bakr. So Abu Bakr, he swore, he said, I'm not going to give him after hurting me. He does not deserve it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, no. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you ease, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you grace from him, do not hold. Do not hold, because if you're going to hold, those people, you're going to help the shaitan be with them. He said, look, now that I did that, you know, they hated me, then they make them, wal-iyadu billah, to be worse. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, your relation with the people, forgive, overlook. Even for the non-believer, actually, for the non-believer, that's what you need to do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Jathiyah, قَالَ قُلْ لِلَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا يَغْفِرُوا لِلَّذِينَ لَا يَرْجُونَ أَيَّامَ اللَّهِ. Say to the believer to forgive for those who are not hoping the days of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's the judge, you are not the judge. So when you come to people, make dua for them, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide them, not make dua against them for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to destroy them, like many people they do. And this is subhanAllah what is going to preserve and help your iman. Maintain a safeguard and increase your iman. The third one, which is the most important, which is the obedience of Allah and His Messenger. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned for us in a big part in Surah An-Nur about those, you know, hypocrites who turn and they do not accept the judgment of Allah and His Messenger. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us to know that obeying Allah and His Messenger is actually a covenant that we have signed up with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is an oath. Because in obeying Allah and His Messenger, that's the core of the deen, that's the core of the submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah the most merciful, He only ordered you things that is mercy. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, He the one, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, kind and merciful, and He only care about you. So following Him is caring about you. Honoring yourself, honoring your iman is truly obeying Allah and His Messenger. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَن يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولُهُ, whoever obey Allah and His Messenger, وَيَخْشَ اللَّهَ, and fear Allah, وَيَتَّقِي, and he show piety and righteousness, those are the successful one. These are, dear brother and sister, in very brief, from Surah An-Nur, take the time to go read it back, and you see, these are the sources of the light, the sources how you can maintain the light of the iman, how you can honor the guest that you have, how you can help yourself being honored by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to regard your akhlaq, to regard your time, to seek your purity, to have your modesty, to forgive to people, and to obey Allah and His Messenger. Those are very simple things, but it requires a lot of effort, and not effort, subhanAllah, of knowledge or effort of burdening yourself, just effort to not put yourself in the places of the darkness where you're going to be, subhanAllah, diverted and away from the light of Allah. And if you are so, then we're going to lose, wal-iyadu billah, because you're not going to have light in the grave, and you're not going to have light in the day of judgment that you need to cross the path as sirat. Now, you're seeing here in brief, as we have presented it, that the identity of the believer is a comprehensive. It's not like, alhamdulillah, I did my prayer, I did my fasting. No, it's a comprehensive. If you pray, you have to be good in your transaction. If you pray and you make fasting, you have to be good in your tongue. You have to say good things. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the best of the people to be. قَالَ وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِّمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. There's better in speech than the one who inviting to Allah and act in his righteousness. People, they do not know who this person. They do not know who this person. He just, acting in goodness, acting in righteousness. He has a good words. He has the words of wisdom. People, they love this person. They can tell you who you are. Who are you? You're going to say, I'm a Muslim. And this is how to be pride of your deen. Because you are a beacon of light. You are a light that you're showing others, subhanAllah, the beauty of this deen. And moreover, one of the greatest characteristics of being a light walking among people, that you're going to be an evidence for the greatness of Allah. Yes, I'm saying it, an evidence. You are a proof for Allah's greatness. The rightest person, he's a proof and hujjah on everyone else on this planet Earth, that Allah is the greatest. How is that? When people, they say, you see in difficulty, you say, alhamdulillah. So, subhanAllah, look at him and say, alhamdulillah. He really has a great God that even in difficulties, he's praising him. When people, they are in difficulty, even in rizq, he said, alhamdulillah, Allah razaq will never let me down. And they see it in your face, not even in your tongue. They see how you're comfortable. They see peace in your face. He said, what a great God these guys have. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it might be that the disbeliever, they wish to be Muslim. Why? Because you are the true evidence if you truly happen to preserve and safeguard the iman in your heart and to be the light as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to be. When you see people relying on Allah, they see people subhanAllah stopping, you are not scared about the future because you have trust and reliance on Allah. And then you are showing to the people the names of Allah. When you see how you trust and confident in the rizq, say, His Lord, He's a Razzaq. His Lord is Al-Wakil. His Lord is Al-Ghani. That's why when the father of Ibrahim alayhi salam, he saw his son coming out of the fire, safe and sound, he was shocked. You know what he said? قَالَ نِعْمَ الرَّبُّ رَبُّكَ يَا إِبْرَهِيمُ. What a great Lord and God you have. This is Ibrahim was the evidence for all his nation of the greatness of Allah. So you are, as a believer Muslim, in this time, in this society, to be an evidence for the greatness of Allah, for the beauty of the deen. And this is, dear brother, if you just take care of the three section, but to know what are the factory of the light and where to find the light. The factory of the light in a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is really what keeps your identity to be strong. If it's not, it's the essence of your identity. In the hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, "At-tahur shatrul iman." Cleanliness or purity is the half of the belief. قال والحمد لله تملأ الميزان. Saying الحمد لله, it fills the whole balance. Can you imagine? قال وسبحان الله وبحمده تملأ ما بين السماوات والأرض. Saying سبحان الله وبحمده, exalted is Allah, and with praising Him سبحانه وتعالى, fill whatever between the heavens and the earth. Can you imagine? Only one word, because you have a strong light in your heart. You are a person who's alive. قال تملأ بين السماوات والأرض. قال والصلاة نور والصدقة برهان والصبر ضياء. الصلاة is light. So your salat, it is the factory of your light. And your sadaqah that you give is a proof. And the proof, subhanAllah, is a strong light to show you the path where to go. And as-sabru dhiya, and subhanAllah, shining light is the patience. And the Quran is going to be either for you, witness for you, or against you. But this is how you choose. Are you going to free yourself and free your neck, as every night you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to free our neck from the hellfire in this month? So it is the key into your hand. And then the other thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make for us, one of His great bounties, subhanAllah, make for you a place where He make descend His light. It is in this masjid and in every masjid in which the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is praised. Can you imagine? You come to the masjid and you are, subhanAllah, inspiring and getting light. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, see, he's teaching us when he used to go to the masjid, he has a dua. He said, "Oh Allah, put in my heart light. Ya Allah, put in my eyes light. Put in my hearing light. Put, Ya Allah, in my tongue light. Put in front of me, behind me, on my right, on my left, on top of me, beneath me, light. And make me, Ya Allah, light." When he's going to the place where the light is descending, and where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, again in Surah An-Nur, when he said, "Allah, eat the light of the heaven and the earth," and in the next ayah he said, "This light descends into the houses that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed to be built." Look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala greatness and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mercy on us. You have a place where the light descends, and you have a factory where you produce life, and you have the section that we have mentioned to look and regard your behavior. This is how you honor yourself. This is how you keep yourself alive. This is how you become an evidence. And when you are an evidence, when you are an evidence for Allah, for the names of Allah, for the greatness of Allah, then in the day of judgment, you're not going to be judged. You're going to be witness, as Allah said in Surah Al-Hajj. You're going to be witness over the other nation. لِتَكُونُ شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ. Why? Because the people, you were the light to show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala way, to show Allah's beauty, to show Allah's deen. But may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to be such a beacon of light and evidence for other and accepted by Allah. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى أما بعد. Dear brother, respected sister, the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which He provides out of His mercy and grace, it is what gives you life. It is what gives you joy and peace in this life. But it becomes more necessary for all of us, especially in these days, to focus, to make a plan. And one of the plans that one has to put really seriously, sincerely, devoutly. And it is a way I'll invite you, and not me invite you, it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to train yourself during this time, the blessed time, to love, to purify yourself. We make it the slogan, inshallah, as in our masjid, to how try to love to purify yourself. By loving to purify yourself, you'll continue in after Ramadan this journey of the purification. You'll continue it. Now the light is more necessary when you think and you remind yourself that the light that is going to be in your grave, are you not asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to illuminate your grave? That's the light of your deeds. That's the light that I'm talking about. If you get to the grave without light, then you will not be able to have a light in the grave. The light that you're going to be resurrected, and the light that is going to help you to travel in the land of resurrection to see where everybody is, the light that is going to help the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to recognize you as a believer, it is this light. Therefore, it becomes like more, subhanAllah, necessary for every one of us, because not only your identity in the dunya to give you joy and peace, but his identity in the akhirah, that's how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be welcoming you in his hawd. You see, so we need it. More than we need it is a necessity, is a necessity. And these days, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala offering for us from his rahmat to build this life, to increase this life, to honor the guests of the iman that we have. Shortly in a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, in the meaning of which, he said, everyone will be provided light based on his or her action. Some of them, قَالَ يُعْتَى جَبَلْ كَجَبَلْ. He will be given an amount of light as a big mountain. SubhanAllah, imagine he has a big mountain. Can you imagine a big mountain? This is his own light that he's going to have in the day of judgment. And of course, you know, in the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, that the marks of the wudu will be in light. But the marks of the wudu, that's where the light will be. But what gives light is your deeds. If someone who will be a liar and betraying and, you know, not fulfilling his promises, the salah and the wudu, they're not going to help. We're talking about those section that we have talking about that you have to regard and work on. So everyone will be given light in this hadith based on his action. So someone will be given as light as a big, as a mountain, the Prophet ﷺ qala, and someone else bigger. Another one will be like a palm tree on his yameen. So imagine you have a palm tree, this is all your light extend. Some of them, you know, less than that. Qala, وَيَكُونُ آخِرَهُمْ مَنْ يُعْتَى نُورَهُ فِي إِبْهَامِ قَدَمِهِ. The last one that will be given, subhanAllah, a light in his toe, in the toe. SubhanAllah, he said, qala, it blinking. Because his deeds, they were not that much. He didn't do, he was not serious, subhanAllah. But still Allah gave him mercy, he still have a little bit of light. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when it blinks, when it lights, he will make one step forward. When subhanAllah is extinguished, he will stop. And he said, then the next, he fall because he's on the sirat. This is your life. You're going to be on top of hellfire, on the path, which is, subhanAllah, sharper than the sword and thinner than the hair. It's only Allah's help who will help you to cross it. So this person, he said, he's almost going to fall, and the fire will hit him on his sides. Till in the end, when he get out, he said, Alhamdulillah, that Allah saved me from you. And Allah told us in Surah Maryam, everyone is going to cross atop of the hellfire. How do you want to cross it? Running like the speed of wind, like the speed of the blink of eye, like the speed of the light. It is depends on the light that you accumulate today in your life. You see how much you are in need in this light. And there's people that are ignoring themselves. When they come in the day of judgment, they see the believer, they say, can we give some of your light? They said, you know, the angel said, no, 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 the light is to be taken from the dunya back. And a big wall comes between them. And he said it has a gate. From one side of the believer is the mercy, and from one side of the disbeliever is the punishment and the doom, wal-iyadu billah. And this is what I'm telling you in Surah Al-Hadid. Those hypocrites, people who were not really fond of the deen of Islam, arguing about the deen, about the ahkam of Allah, and they think still they are believers, they might not have the light, and then they're going to regret it much. But we say, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to understand, to help us, to guide us, to love the purification, to collect and accumulate the light, to honor the guest of iman in our heart, to be an evidence for the greatness of Allah, to be a beacon of light walking among people, to be accepted by Allah, to enlighten, will be able by the help of Allah to enlighten our grave, to enlighten our limbs, to be recognized by the Prophet, to be with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, walking and making this dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Tahrim, O Allah, complete our light and forgive us. You have power over all, everything. Rabbana atmim lana nurana واغفر لنا إنك على كل شيء قدير اللهم اغفر لنا يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اعتق رقابنا من النار اللهم اجعلنا من عتقائك من النار في هذا الشهر الكريم اللهم إنك كريم عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم عافنا واعف عنا عافنا واعف عنا وإلى الصلاة يرحمكم الله
الله أكبر الله